إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونسترضيه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صل اللهم وسلم وبارك وزد على رسول الله وآله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
Sheikh started by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and saying that we praise Allah, we seek His forgiveness, and we seek refuge with Allah from the evil of ourselves and the evil of our actions. And then he stated that I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah alone, and I further bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu ittaqullaha haqqa tuqatih.
O you who believe, fear your Creator, the correct way He should be feared.
وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ.
And die not except in a state of Islam as Muslims.
يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ وَاخْشَوْا يَوْمًا لَا يَجْزِي وَالِدٌ عَنْ وَلَدِهِ.
O mankind, fear your Lord and remember a day when a son will not be able to help his father.
وَلَا مَوْلُودٌ هُوَ جَازٍ عَنْ وَالِدِهِ شَيْئًا.
And the day on which a son will not be able to help his father.
إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقَّ.
Truly the promise of Allah is true.
فَلَا تَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا.
And do not be deceived by this world.
وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورُ.
And do not be deceived away from your Creator Allah.
يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ.
O mankind, fear your Lord, as truly the earthquake at the hour when the world ends is something terrible.
يوم ترونها تزهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت.
The day on which you see every mother suckling her baby, abandon her suckling baby.
وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها.
And this is the day when every pregnant woman will miscarry.
وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى.
Then on this day man will be as though he is intoxicated even though he is not intoxicated.
ولكن عذاب الله شديد.
However, the punishment of Allah is severe.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله.
O you who believe, fear Allah.
اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا.
Fear your Lord and say a correct word.
يصلح لكم أعمالكم.
And He will improve and make correct your affairs.
ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم.
And He will forgive your sins.
ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما.
Whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger, then he has indeed succeeded a great success. And then to continue, that the most truthful of speech is the Book of Allah. And the best guidance is the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the most evil matters are those which are innovative.
وإن كل محدثة بدعة.
And every innovative matter is a بدعة.
وإن كل بدعة ضلالة.
And every بدعة is a misguidance.
وإن كل ضلالة في النار.
And every misguidance is in the hellfire.
مرحبا بأحبابي وإخواني في الله.
And to welcome you, my dear beloved brothers and sisters in Islam.
مرحبا بكم إخواني في بيت من بيوت الله.
Now welcome my brothers in a house from the houses of Allah.
مرحبا بمن من الله عليهم بلا إله إلا الله.
Welcome to those who Allah has given a gift of لا إله إلا الله. There is none worthy of worship except God.
مرحبا بأحباب الذين أجر الله على ألسنتهم ليقولوا لا إله إلا الله.
Now welcome to the one who Allah has made it easy on his tongue to say that there is none worthy of worship except Allah.
أحبتي وإخواني في الله.
My dear beloved brothers and sisters in Islam.
تعالوا نتكلم.
Then let us speak.
عن الإسلام.
About Islam.
في نقطتين اثنتين.
In two points.
أولا.
The first point.
لماذا الإسلام؟
That why should we choose Islam?
والأمر الثاني.
And the second matter.
هل تذوقت حلاوة الإيمان؟
That have you tasted the sweetness of faith?
لماذا الإسلام؟
That why should we choose Islam?
لأنه دين الفطرة.
Because it is the natural religion.
والله دين الفطرة.
That it is the natural religion.
لن تستطيع أن تأتي بأمر.
That you are unable to come with a matter.
موجود في الإسلام.
That is present and present in Islam.
يخالف الفطرة.
That it opposes the natural state of man.
أبداً أبداً.
That you'll never find anything like this ever.
لا كبير ولا صغير.
Nor a small matter, nor a big matter.
يخالف الفطرة.
That it opposes the natural state of man.
الأمر الثاني.
The second issue.
لا يخالف العقل.
And it also it does not oppose the intellect.
جميع أوامر الإسلام.
That all the commandments in Islam.
من أجل ذلك.
Because of this.
لما دعا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
That when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he called.
إلى الإسلام.
To Islam.
كيف كان حال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
What was the condition of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
هل كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من أغنى أغنياء مكة؟
Was the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم the richest man in Mecca؟
فأنفق عليهم الأموال ليقولوا لا إله إلا الله؟
That did he give them money such that they should say لا إله إلا الله there's none worthy of worship؟
أجيبوا عليه هل كان من أغنياء مكة؟
That was the Prophet Muhammad from the rich people in Mecca صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هل كان من أغنياء مكة؟
The answer this question was he from those people who are rich in مكة؟
أجيبه.
The answer this question.
ما كان من أغنياء مكة؟
That no, he was not from the wealthy people in مكة.
إذن فكيف انتشر الإسلام في مكة؟
Then how did Islam spread in مكة؟
كيف يترك الملياردير أبي بكر الصديق؟
نعم. ما سمعت الشيخ؟
لماذا دخل أبي بكر الصديق؟
Now why did Abu Bakr as-Siddiq enter Islam?
وكان أبي بكر الصديق من أغنى أغنياء مكة.
And Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he was from one of the most wealthy people in Mecca.
هل دخل طمعا في المال؟
That did he enter out of greed for wealth?
لا والله.
Not because of this.
إنما دخل في الإسلام.
That Abu Bakr he became a Muslim.
لأن الإسلام لا يخالف فطرة.
Because Islam it does not oppose the natural state of man.
وما جاء بأمر فيه خلل أبدا.
He never came with a matter in which there was a fault ever.
وتعالى أكرر عليك ما قلته منذ شهر هنا.
That I wanted to repeat something which I said here one month ago.
حينما سأل النجاشي وكان رجل نصراني.
And there was a king and his name was Najashi and he was a Christian.
اقرأوا سيرة النجاشي.
And read the life story of النجاشي.
أي دين كان يدين به النجاشي؟
And which religion did النجاشي follow?
كان أي ديانة؟
What religion did he follow?
النصرانية.
He was a Christian.
لما جاء أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى الحبشة.
And when the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went to Eritrea to meet this Christian king النجاشي.
وأرادت مكة أن تعود بأصحاب رسول الله.
And the people of Mecca they wanted that the people of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم return.
فكان النجاشي.
And then النجاشي.
مع أنه كان مخالف لنا في الدين.
That even though النجاشي he opposed us he had a different religion.
ولكن قال النبي في حقه.
And however, the Prophet ﷺ said about him
رجل
that he was a man
لا يظلم عنده أحد
that he never oppresses anybody with him.
هكذا الدين الإسلام.
And this is the nature of the religion of Islam.
لا يظلم أحد
that he never oppresses anybody.
قال الله رب العالمين في سورة النساء.
And Allah, the Lord of the worlds, has said in the fourth chapter of the Quran, Surah An-Nisa
ولا يجرمنكم شنآن قوم
that let not the hatred of a people
على ألا تعدلوا
such that you should not be just
اعدلوا
that you should be just
هو أقرب للتقوى
and this is closer to piety
مهما كان المخالف لك
that whatever the person he opposed you with.
بل في كتابنا نتعبد لله رب العالمين.
And the book with which we worship Allah.
ونتقرب بكلام ربنا.
And we use these words to get closer to Allah.
وهو يقول للعالم.
And Allah, he says to the whole world.
ويقول للإنسانية.
And he says to the whole of humanity.
لكم دينكم ولي دين.
That you have your religion and we have our religion.
ولكن اسمع إلى النجاشي.
However, listen to the words of the Christian king
النجاشي.
And he is listening to someone called Ja'far.
وسأل جعفر.
And Ja'far, he said to the Christian king النجاشي.
أي دين؟
That which religion?
تركتم فيه الوطن.
That you left your homes for.
وتركتم فيه الأولاد.
And you left your children for.
وتركتم فيه الأموال.
And you left your wealth for.
وجئتم إلى بلاد.
And you came to our country.
ليست هي بلادكم.
And this country is not your country.
وليس لكم أحد فيها.
And there's nobody who belongs to you here.
أخبروني من هو محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
He said, "Tell me who is Muhammad."
قالوا له أيها الملك.
And Ja'far said to An-Najashi, "O king."
اسمع كما قلت لك أن الإسلام دين فطرة دين عقل.
Listen, like I said to you before, that Islam is a religion of intellect and a religion of it's a natural religion.
قالوا للنجاشي.
And they said to An-Najashi,
أيها الملك.
They said, "O king."
انظر إلى الأدب.
Look at their manners.
أيها الملك.
That oh king.
لقد كنا في جاهلية.
That we used to be in a period of ignorance.
نأكل الميتة.
And we used to eat carrion, dead meat.
ونشرب الخمر.
And we used to drink alcohol.
ونؤذي البنات.
And we used to harm our daughters.
ونكذب في الحديث.
And we used to lie in our speech.
ونسيء الجوار.
And we used to be bad to our neighbors.
وأخذ يذكر له من سلبيات الجاهلية.
And he started to mention those negative things that they used to do in the period of ignorance.
إلى أن من الله علينا بمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Until Allah, he sent us the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
بما أمركم محمد.
And then An-Najashi asked that, "What did Muhammad command you with?"
قال أمرنا بالصدق في الحديث.
And he said that Muhammad, he commanded us to be honest in our speech.
وبأداء الأمانة.
And to fulfill our trusts.
وبنبذ الأصنام وعبادة الله الواحد الأحد.
And to throw away the statues and to worship Allah the one.
وبالوفاء بالعهد.
And to fulfill our trusts and promises.
والإحسان إلى الناس.
And to be kind to the people.
فقال النجاشي.
And Najashi, the Christian king, he said.
هل معكم شيئا مما جاء به محمد؟
Do you have with you anything which the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم he came with?
أريد منك أن تسمع بقلب.
And I want you now to listen not with your ears but with your heart.
وأقسم بك بالله.
And I swear by Allah.
أن تقول في نفسك.
That you should say to yourself.
لا أريد أن أسمعها منك.
That I don't want to hear it from you.
هل هذا الكلام كلام بشر أم كلام رب البشر؟
Ask yourself: Is this the speech of God or is this the speech of the God of man?
أريد منك أن تسمع بقلبك.
And I want you to listen with your heart.
كافى يا عين صاد.
Sheikh, he's reciting from the beginning of Surah Maryam, the chapter of Mary.
ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا.
And mention to them about your slave Zakaria, who was one of the prophets.
نادى ربه نداء خفيا.
When Zakaria, he called to his Lord a very slow call.
قال رب إني وهن العظم مني واشتعل الرأس شيبا.
And Zakaria said to his Lord that my bones have become weak and my hair has become grey.
ولم أكن بدعائك رب شقيا.
And let me not be one of the losers with regards to my dua.
وأخذ جعفر يقرأ.
And Ja'far, he started to read these verses from the Quran.
حتى وصل إلى
until he reached the statement of Allah.
الحديث عن مريم.
The statements regarding Mary.
مريم عليها السلام.
Mary, may Allah's peace be upon her.
مريم المكرمة في القرآن والسنة.
Mary, who is honored in the Quran and in the prophetic traditions.
ومن أعظم تكريم لها.
And the most honorable thing for her.
ما وجدنا له مثيلا في أي مكان ولا في أي كتاب.
And we never found anything similar to this in any place or in any book.
هل يوجد في القرآن سورة تسمى بسورة فاطمة الزهراء؟
That is there a chapter in the Quran which is named after the daughter of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Fatima?
هل يوجد؟
Is there a chapter named after the daughter of the Prophet?
يوجد؟
Is there?
هل المصاحف؟ هل يوجد؟
No, there isn't.
هل يوجد سورة تسمى بسورة خديجة حبيبة النبي؟
Is there a chapter in the Quran named after the wife of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, Khadija?
يوجد؟
Is there?
يوجد؟
No, no, there isn't.
هل يوجد سورة في القرآن تسمى بحبيبة النبي عائشة؟
That is there a chapter in the Quran named after Aisha, the beloved wife of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
يوجد.
Is there?
توجد سورة تسمى الحسن أو الحسين رضي الله عنهما؟
Is there a chapter in the Quran named after the grandsons of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, حسن and حسين؟
سيدا شباب أهل الجنة.
And these are the youth of the people of paradise.
هل يوجد؟
Is there?
هل يوجد سورة تسمى بسورة مريم؟
Is there a chapter in the Quran called the chapter of Mary?
نتعبد باسم مريم لله رب العالمين.
That we mention the name of Maryam when we are worshiping, we're reading this Quran.
هل يستطيع مسلم أن يحذف حرفا من كلمة مريم؟
That is a Muslim allowed to delete even a letter from the word Maryam?
فتسمى سورة مريم تكريما وتعظيما وتشريفا لها.
And this chapter is called the chapter of Mary out of honor towards Mary, the mother of Jesus.
بل جعلها الله آية للعالمين.
Rather, Allah has made her a sign for the whole of the world.
وضرب الله مثلا للذين آمنوا امرأة فرعون إذ قالت رب ابن لي عندك بيتا في الجنة.
And Allah gave an example, the example of the wife of Fir'aun when she made the dua, Ya Allah, make for me a house in paradise. And save me from Pharaoh and his evil actions. And save me from the oppressive people. And listen.
ومريم ابنة عمران التي أحصنت فرجها.
And Mary, the daughter of Imran, the one who protected her private parts.
فنفخنا فيه من روحنا.
And we blew into her a soul from the souls which Allah has with him.
وصدقت بكلمات ربها وكتبه.
And she believed in the words of her Lord and his books.
وكانت من القانتين.
And she was from the devout, pious people.
لما قرأ.
And when he read.
جعفر على النجاشي.
And when Ja'far he read to this Christian king النجاشي.
صدر سورة مريم.
From the beginning of the chapter of Mary.
وصل الحديث عن ولادة عيسى عليه السلام.
Until he reached the verses of the Quran which talk about the birth of Jesus.
وعيسى يوجد عندنا في القرآن.
And is the name of Jesus found in the Quran?
يوجد.
Is there?
كم مرة ذكر عيسى؟
How many times is the name of Jesus found in the Quran?
من يجيب إن شاء الله رب العالمين سوف يأخذ من أخي مسعود خمسة.
Whoever answers this question will take from me £5.
كم؟
How many times is Jesus mentioned in the Quran?
25.
25 يقول.
25.
No.
ذكر عيسى عليه السلام.
Jesus is mentioned in the Quran.
نعم. كما قال أخي.
As the brother here has correctly said.
أظن يعني أنا يمكن أشك عندي أنا.
I'm not certain myself.
125 مرة أو 25.
He said I'm not sure if it's 125 or 25.
لو افترضنا 25.
If we say, just for example, that Jesus is mentioned 25 times in the Quran.
عيسى يذكر 25 مرة.
Jesus is mentioned 25 times in the Quran.
ومحمد.
And how many times is Muhammad mentioned?
لا 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 لا. حينما أقول محمد قل صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Whenever I say Muhammad, say peace be upon him.
من لم يصلي على النبي يدفع خمسة دراهم.
That whoever does not say peace be upon him has to pay £5.
صلى الله وسلم على رسوله. نعم. كم مرة؟
How many times is Muhammad mentioned in the Quran? Five times.
أربع مرات. باسم محمد.
Four times using the actual name Muhammad.
ومرة واحدة باسم أحمد.
And once using his other name Ahmad.
ومن أعجب الأحوال.
And something amazing.
أن الذي قال اسم أحمد هو عيسى عليه السلام.
And the amazing thing is that the one who described the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم as Ahmad is Jesus himself.
في سورة الصف.
In the chapter of As-Saff.
وإذ قال عيسى بن مريم.
And when Jesus, the son of Mary, he said, when Jesus said, O children of Israel, I have come as a messenger to you, confirming that which came in the Torah, in the Torah, and giving you glad tidings of a prophet who will come after. His name is? His name is?
Ahmad.
His name is Ahmad. If you did an equation when you look at the number of times that Jesus is mentioned in the Quran and the number of times that Muhammad is mentioned in the Quran, you will find the equation. You will find that Jesus is mentioned many, many more times than Muhammad is mentioned in the Quran. Yes. And when An-Najashi, this Christian king, when he heard the verses about the birth of Jesus, and she became pregnant with Jesus. Mary became pregnant with Jesus and she went to a faraway place. And the pains of childbirth, they drew her to a palm tree, and she took hold of the palm tree and she said, I wish I died, when she felt this pain. I wish I died and nobody ever remembered me ever again. And the voice of Jesus came from below her.
So
Jesus, he spoke to his mother and said, look, Allah has made for you a stream. And Ja'far, he was reading these verses to An-Najashi. And then something amazing happened during the recitation of the Quran. When Allah, he ordered Mary, that when Mary has given birth to Jesus and she takes him to her people, that don't say anything when you show Jesus to the people. And who will speak to the people? And who will speak to the people?
Isa alayhi salam.
Jesus, he will speak to the people.
Isa ibn al-yawm al-awwal sawfa yatakallam.
And Jesus, he will speak on the first day after his birth.
Na'am, sawfa yatakallam al-an.
And yes, Jesus will now speak.
Isma' madha qala Isa alayhi salam.
And listen what Jesus said to his people.
Fa-sharat ilayhi.
So Mary, she pointed to Jesus.
فأشارت إليه قالوا كيف نكلم من كان في المهد صبيا.
And she pointed to him and they said, how can we speak to a baby who is still in the cradle?
أول كلمة خرجت من فيه عيسى.
And the first word which came out of the mouth of Jesus.
قال إني عبد الله.
And the first words which Jesus he uttered was, I am the slave of God.
قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا.
He said, I am the slave of God. He has given me a book and he has made me a prophet.
وَجَعَلَنِي مُبَارَكًا أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُ وَأَوْصَانِي بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ.
And he has made me blessed wherever I go and he has commanded me to observe the prayers and pay the zakat.
وَأَوْصَانِي بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ مَا دُمْتُ حَيًّا.
And he has told me to offer the prayers and give the zakat as long as I am alive.
وَبَرًّا
and to be good to my mother. And he did not tell me to be an oppressive person. And peace be upon me the day I am born and the day I die and the day I am raised.
ذلك عيسى بن مريم قول الحق الذي فيه يمترون.
And this is the story of Jesus, son of Mary, the story in which they doubt.
ما كان لله أن يتخذ من ولد سبحانه.
And it was not befitting for God, for Allah to take a son. May he be free of this.
إذا قضى أمرا فإنما يقول له كن فيكون.
Whenever Allah he decrees a matter, all he has to say is be and it is. And this Christian king Al-Najashi, he was listening. And then until Dujashi, he cried a lot. And all the bishops and priests around him, they also wept. And then he said this word. He said, by Allah, the thing which Muhammad has come with, and the thing which Jesus, son of Mary, he came with, that they both come from exactly the same place. And he said to the Muslims that, go, you are now free to live in our land. And a few days later, and then Najashi,
لما وصل إليه كتاب النبي.
And then when he received a letter from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
أسلم وقال لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله.
And then An-Najashi, this Christian king, he became a Muslim and he said that there is none worthy of worship except Allah and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah.
فهذا هو على الإسلام دين عقل ودين فطرة.
And this is the religion of Islam. It is the most natural religion and it is a religion which conforms with the intellect.
هل تستطيع أن تأتي الآن؟
Are you able to come with something now?
تأتي بشيء فيه خلل.
And are you able to come with anything, a defect?
في القرآن.
In the Quran.
أو فيما صح عن رسول الله.
Or any statement which is authentically reported from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
لا تسمع عن الإسلام.
That don't just listen to Islam from other people.
لا تسمع عنه.
That don't just listen about Islam.
ولكن اسمع منه.
Rather listen from the Muslims.
تريد أن تسمع من الإسلام.
That do you want to listen from Islam itself?
تريد أن تسمع من الإسلام.
Do you want to hear from Islam itself?
كيف أسمع من الإسلام.
That how can we listen to Islam?
عليك بقال الله وقال رسوله.
Then you should refer to what Allah said and what the Messenger said. And that you will find the answer. And you will find that the answer is very simple and easy, inshallah. That Islam is a great blessing. That ask yourself. And remember. And remind yourself. And that the heavens. And the mountains. And the earth, and the sun which is behind the moon, and then sometimes the moon is behind the sun. That who is making all this happen? Who is making this go round and round? Who? That if your car is stopped in the road, that are you able to carry your car on your back? Are you able to do this? Why are you unable to carry the car on your shoulders? Because you are somebody who is weak. So how about the earth and the mountains and the skies? Is a human being able to carry this? Is anybody able to do this? Yes. Glorified to Allah, Lord of the worlds. That, O brother in Islam, O beloved person in Islam, that reflect upon yourself. And until you get the chance. The chance. That catch yourself. That catch yourself. Because death, that death is very, very close.
إما أن تموت وأنت مسلم.
That you will die either you are a Muslim.
وإما والعياذ بالله الأخرى.
You will die in another state. May Allah protect us from this. I ask Allah, the Lord of the Great Throne, that nobody leaves his gathering except that his chest is feeling open, and that his heart is feeling illuminated with the light of Islam and with the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the second, second issue, very quickly. And in Islam there is a sweetness that the people who have faith, that they sense this sweetness in their hearts. That don't think that just because you say that there is none worthy of worship except Allah and that Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah, that you will not be tried and tested. That you will not be tested. That this is a mistake to think you will not be tested. How do you know whether your friend he likes you or he does not like you? How do you know this? If you made a meal, that naturally he will come. Because it's food. May Allah grant us food. That he will come, your friend will come. That whenever a problem occurs, that you have a debt, and the bank, or the person who owns the money, that he requires the money now. That you know now your friend. Isn't that the case? When you contact him, that when he sees your number on the phone,
Allah, oh,
then he will say, oh,
I am sorry.
Then he will lock the phone. Oh. If it was not like this, if he was your real friend, he will come to you. And for Allah is the best examples. And he wants to test his slaves and the people of Iman. And because of this, the Prophet Muhammad said, listen, that the people who are tested the most severely are the prophets. And the prophets. The prophets. That the prophets are those who were tested the most severely. The Prophet Ayyub, he was tested for 17 years. He was ill. And he had no food and no drink. Except a little bit. And what about the Prophet Sallallahu
Alaihi Wasallam?
And he was the Imam of the people of Iman, of faith. And I said to my brothers and sisters in Islam in the last Jumu'ah prayer in Leeds, and that now we will speak about the true happiness. And we said, by the favor of Allah, that you will never find happiness in a bottle of alcohol. That you want to flee from yourselves. And that you want to run away from your life. And that you want to run away from yourself. That you want to come with something which will make your senses go. That it's not relevant whether your intellect, your that you want to stop thinking, you want to drink alcohol. And you want to come with a false happiness. However, you'll never find happiness in just a glass of alcohol. Shall I tell you how to find real happiness? That you will only find true happiness in worshipping your Lord. And test yourself. Say now, and you're sitting here. I want from you now, and to say,
Allah.
Say Allah, the word Allah.
Allah.
In one breath, to say Allah.
Allah.
Do you feel and sense anything within yourself? Yes, by Allah.
ليست السعادة أبدا.
The true happiness.
في أن تبتعد عن الله.
That the true happiness is not found in distancing yourself from Allah.
بل لتتقرب إلى الله.
However, when you come closer to Allah.
ووالله العظيم.
By Allah.
ما حرم عليك شيء.
That Allah did not prohibit anything.
إلا وهو في مصلحتك.
Except that it is for your welfare, for your benefit.
لماذا حرم ربي الخمر؟
Then why did Allah He forbade the drinking of alcohol?
لا أتي بحديث ولا بالقرآن.
Then I'm not going to mention anything from the Quran or from the Sunnah.
انظر إلى الواقع الآن.
Then just look at the situation today.
كم من الضحايا وملايين من البشر.
Then how many millions of people?
في المستشفيات.
That they're in the hospitals.
وكان سبب موتهم الخمر.
And the reason for their death was alcohol.
من أجل ذلك حرمها الإسلام.
And for this reason, Islam it prohibited man from drinking alcohol.
راجع الأبحاث العلمية.
And why was the pork forbidden? Just look at the medical studies.
لماذا حرم الزنا؟
And why was fornication prohibited?
أما سمعت عن مرض الإيدز؟
Have you never heard of an illness called AIDS?
لماذا حرم ربي لمصلحتك؟
Why did Allah prohibit these things for your welfare and benefit?
نعم يا أحبابي إخواني.
Yes, my.
الأمر الذي أريد أن أكد عليه أنه حلاوة الإيمان.
The thing I wanted to emphasize was the sweetness of faith.
ولكن ليس معنى أنك تجد حلاوة الإيمان ألا تبتلى كما قلت.
That this does not mean the sweetness of faith does not mean that you won't be tested.
على عجلة إن شاء الله في الكلام كذلك.
And we're in a hurry, quickly.
النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
يبدأ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حياته صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he started his life
بدون أن يرى أباه.
Without having seen the face of his father.
ثم بعد.
And then thereafter.
صلى الله عليه وسلم.
صلى الله عليه وسلم.
6 سنين يفقد الأم.
And then at the age of 6 he lost his mother.
ثم بعد سنتين.
And then 2 years after that.
يفقد الجد الشفوق الحنون عليه.
And then he lost his beloved grandfather.
ثم يبدأ في رعي الأنغام الأغنام.
And then he started as a shepherd looking after sheep.
ثم يصل صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى سن 25 سنة.
And then he reached the age of 25.
ويتزوج صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And he married.
ويدعو إلى الله رب العالمين في سن 40.
And then at the age of 40 he started calling man to worship Allah.
ويدعو إلى عبادة أن لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله.
And he started calling man to worship Allah alone and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah.
وما هي إلا بعد سنوات قليلات.
And then after a few years,
يموت العم.
And then his uncle died.
الذي كان مدافع كذلك عنه.
Who used to defend him.
انظر الإسلام لما يعطي لكل ذي حق حقه.
And then when Islam it gives every person who has a right his right.
ما كان عم النبي مسلما.
And that the uncle of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he was not a Muslim.
هل كان مسلما؟
Was he a Muslim?
لم يكن مسلما.
He wasn't a Muslim.
ومع ذلك نقول بكل ما نملك أنه كان واقفا بجوار النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And despite not being a Muslim, he used to support and stand next to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ثم بعد موت العم.
And then when his uncle died.
تموت حبيبة النبي.
And then his beloved daughter died.
فيحزن عليها حزنا شديدا.
And he was very saddened by the death of his daughter.
ثم يموت أولاد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم البنات.
And then his daughters, all of them, they passed away.
رقية. يأمر بتكفينها.
And then he ordered that she should be wrapped in the shroud and her body should be washed. And then he prayed over her. And then his daughter Umm Kulthum also passed away. And then Zainab also passed away. And the Prophet ﷺ, he was patient, hoping for the reward from his Lord. And he was always smiling in life. Because all of this is the command of whom? The command of who? The command of
Allah.
And he must be pleased with the decree of Allah because it's from Allah. And then his sons, they died, they passed away. And he had 3 sons. Now the first one, he passed away. And the sons of the Prophet, most of them, they didn't live more than 1 month or 3 months. And one died after the other. And the Prophet was patient, hoping for the reward from his Lord. Until his final son, he came. May Allah be pleased with him. And his name was Abraham. And Abraham, he became old.
And 16
until he became 16 months old.
ويمسك النبي بيديه.
And the Prophet, he took hold of his hands.
ويخرج به صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى المسجد.
And he used to take him to the mosque.
تخيل لما ترى ابن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And you can imagine when you see the son of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هل أنت متخيل المشهد؟
Can you imagine this?
أنك ترى ابن سيد ولد آدم صلى الله عليه وسلم.
You are seeing the son of the best of the children of Adam.
فيجري الناس عليه الصحابة.
And the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وبالفعل يا أحباب إخواني يصل ابن النبي إلى 16 شهرا.
And then the son of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he reached 16 months.
وترسل إليه زوجته ماريا المصرية.
And then, and his wife Maria, she sent to him. And she sent to him a message saying that your son Ibrahim, he is not well. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he went to his son Ibrahim. And he found him in the last moments of his life. So he took his son and he held him to his chest. And his son Abraham, he was breathing very, very slowly. Until he died, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was holding his son. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he wept. And he said his famous words. He said, "O Ibrahim." And he said that the eye it weeps. And the heart it feels sadness. However, we will not say except that which pleases Allah. To Allah we belong and to Him we will return. And if we looked at the life of the Prophet ﷺ in order, we would not finish. That periods of time they come and they did not even light a fire in his house. And his wife Aisha said that in the house we only ate and had food, the two black things. Meaning the water and the dates. And he, even with all this, he was the happiest person. Do you know why he was so happy? Why? Because he knew that all of this happened as a command of who? Because it was everything that happened to him was the command of Allah, Lord of the worlds. And now you are being tested. After you have become a Muslim. Either you affirm as a Muslim. And inshallah you will be affirmed as a Muslim. And that the greatest matters by the permission of Allah. That will make you a strong Muslim. And that you should take care of your prayers. And the second matter. And to have good companionship. And the last point and the third point. Every day read a small portion of the Quran. And be strong, my brothers in Islam. And I want to ask a question. That if there is someone here today who is not a Muslim, that we ask the question that what do you know about Islam? Does anybody want to answer? Is everybody a Muslim? If anybody has any questions, are there any questions you would like to ask me? Are you all hungry?
No.
This is a great, great answer. I am the hungriest from you. May Allah reward you.
So it was told by Jesus. Is it by Jesus told or the angel told that?
هو يسأل في سورة مريم القول يعني تحت كسرية هل هذا قول الملك أو قول عيسى ابن مريم؟
الأمر فيه القرآن ليس فيه اختلاف على الإطلاق.
That we should know that in the Quran that there is no contradiction or difference.
على الإطلاق ليس فيه أدنى اختلاف.
There is no difference about the Quran.
ولكن فهم القرآن.
However, to understand the Quran.
والعرب هم أصحاب الفصاحة.
And that the Arabs, they are the most eloquent people.
وأصحاب اللغة.
And they are the people who have the Arabic language.
وجاء القرآن بلغة عربية.
And that the Quran, it was revealed in the Arabic language.
وجاء يتحدى العرب.
And it came as a challenge to the Arabs.
فهنا لأهل العلم.
And here the scholars.
قولان.
And that they have two different opinions in this matter. That the first opinion, and that they say that the voice which came from below Mary, that it was Jesus himself. And the second opinion amongst the scholars, and that the one who called her, and other scholars, they hold that he was the angel Jibreel, Gabriel, who called her. And then maybe you ask yourself the question that how did he call her from below her? That if it was Jesus, then of course he was being given birth to, so he called from below her. That, however, how could it be such that the angel called from below her? That don't let the shaitan, the devil, let you think that he was below her and she was above him. It's not like that. That when you look at this phrase from below her, that if you were standing and I am sitting, that you are standing above me and I am sitting below you. So we should know that there is no contradiction in the Quran. That all of it is acceptable, that the mind can accept everything that is said. That I wanted to say something. That there is nothing in this religion, in Islam, that there's nothing in Islam that we feel embarrassed or shy to speak about. Mention any issue. That don't think that I know everything, I don't claim to know everything. That don't even think that the Prophet ﷺ, he knows everything. Who knows absolutely everything? Allah.
No,
who knows everything?
Allah.
That if I don't know,
maybe
somebody else knows. And do you know why? Because Allah has said, Allah has said, ask the people of knowledge if you don't know. Are there any other questions?
Alhamdulillah.
All praises to Allah. I wanted to thank my brothers in Islam and all brothers who organized this gathering. All of the brothers who organized this gathering. And that they honored me. That this is a great honor. That I am here to speak to my brothers. And that I speak with you. In the best and sweetest, most enjoyable of speech. To speak about the King of the Kings, and that is Allah, Lord of the Worlds. By Allah. That if you speak even for a long time about Allah, Lord of the Worlds, that you will feel with security and peace and tranquility. And I wanted to give you some good tidings. That last Friday or Thursday when I spoke about happiness, that when they heard about Allah and His Messenger, they said that Islam is beauty and mercy and perfection. But before, they never knew that Islam had mercy and these kind of things. The only thing they ever heard was that Islam is about cutting off hands. And about killing. That the Muslims, they like to torture women. May Allah protect us from them.
والله العظيم يا أحبابي أبدا.
Not never.
أبداً.
Islam is not like this. الحمد لله my wife isn't here.
الحمد لله رب العالمين ليس في ديننا شيء أبدا يعني اسأل وسوف يجيب عليك أي عالم من العلماء من أهل العلم.
There is nothing to be embarrassed about in our religion. One of the scholars will respond, will answer.
لماذا سوف يجيب؟
Do you know why he will be able to answer?
لأننا كما بدأنا نختم.
Because as we started, we will finish. Because the religion of Islam is a religion which is the natural state of man and one which conforms to the intellect. After we said that true happiness is found in the obedience to Allah. And the person who was translating for me at that time.
بأن امرأة قد أسلمت في المسجد بفضل الله رب العالمين.
And because of the speech the Sheikh gave in Leeds last week, that a woman actually accepted Islam.
بل قيل أنها صرخت بأعلى ما فيها من شدة الفرح عن دين الله.
Rather, she shouted out of happiness because she was so happy to have become a Muslim.
فأسأل الله رب العالمين أحبابي إخواني في الله لنا ولكم الهداية جميعا.
We ask Allah to guide us all. Lord of the world, and to make us strong as Muslims, and to make us live as Muslims, and to raise us on the Day of Judgment amongst the gathering of the Muslims, and to lighten our hearts, to illuminate our hearts with that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. May Allah reward you all. And all praises to Allah, Lord of the world. Jazakallah khairan, Sheikh Talat, for having delivered that very useful introduction to Islam. Alhamdulillah, we're very honored. Today we have Brother Nick, who recently became a Muslim, now known as Abdul Salam. His Asian name, he said. His Pakistani name is Abdul Salam, and his Yorkshire name is Nick. We also have two other very esteemed guests here. Keith, we have Keith in the corner here, who is here from Elland. And we have also Michael, who is from Osset. So two Yorkshiremen as well here, amongst Yorkshiremen. And we hope, inshallah, they will not only be Yorkshiremen, but also, inshallah, be our brothers in Islam. And please make them feel welcome. And we ask Allah that He helps us establish these gatherings, because we wish to spread the message of Islam in the region. And we want to see more and more people knowing that Islam is a religion of peace and mercy and love. And inshallah, now we will share some food, and thereafter we will lead Salat al-Isha prayers. And again, to thank all the brothers who donated the food today.